Give me 2 minutes or less to show you how you can add a style to Map Engine. For this we are going to use Mapbox, but you can use any tile server that has a free tier or paid one if you're willing to pay. Open any browser and then go to mapbox.com. At this point you have to create an account. I have already set one up. For the free tier, you also have to set up a payment method, which is a bit of a bummer, but you won't be charged anything unless you go out of the bounds of the free tier. Because I have already created an account, I will just have to log in. From here, go to the style editor and ignore all of this new style and so on. We are going to explore that later in the video. Instead, go to Find Inspiration in the Style Gallery. Unfortunately, you cannot add every style. For example, this mineral style right here is really, really beautiful, but there's no Add to Mapbox Studio button, which is kinda needed to get the style to Map Engine or GeoLayers. After a bit of searching, I found this Standard Oil Company preset, and you can actually add this to your studio. So, click this button and you will be redirected to the map style editor. For this example, I don't want to customize anything, I just want to go to publish and then publish and then go to share, third party, change WMTS to Kato and then just copy. Now go to After Effects and GeoLayers, or in my case Map Engine and Fusion, and activate the script. Immediately you are prompted to enter your resolution, and then right here you can add a new style. And just paste in what you've just copied and maybe give it a name. Let's click OK. This can take a bit of time and then Map Engine will automatically download the preview, so let's just click on it. Map Engine has built out this node structure and we can just put this into the viewer. Let's go to Europe. And these are still low resolution proxy tiles, so let's get the high resolution ones to get a bit more detail. Downloading these for the very first time can take a bit longer because they are not yet cached. That's basically it. It's so simple to add these pre-made styles. Now when we customize this map, I will show you a little neat trick that will speed this process up by 4 times. It's so simple but so genius, so let's get right into customizing. Here in Mapbox, the layer is still open, so let's go back to Styles, there's Standard Oil Company, and on the three dots we can duplicate. I'll just open up this copied style, and here's all this text. What we can do is just click on the text. And here you can see what we've just clicked on. And there's a subsection Place Labels. Let's click on the place labels. Here on the left you can change the styling, but we don't want to change the color of the text or the font, we want to just get rid of it. So even further on the left, there's all these features. And somewhere has to be labels. With place labels selected, just go to the delete component button and delete component. Yep, we want to remove the labels. That has gotten rid of a bunch of labels, but there's still these other ones. What are those? Points of interest labels. Okay, let's go to points of interest labels and get rid of them too. Pretty close to the top, points of interest labels, get rid of them. Yep, remove. That has gotten rid of those labels. What's left is like the United States labels, North Atlantic Ocean, and these really big places. Go to the left, country labels. What's under there? Yeah, there's big, medium, small, select it and just get rid of it. Then there's land and water labels, so natural features, water point label. Search for this and natural features, water point label. And there's all these labels under here, so just get rid of all of it. Remove. Now we have a really clean map. Let's just go up here, hit publish and publish. This will take a while, hit OK. And then again, go to share, third party, changed from WMTS to Kato and copy the link. And now we will just move back to Fusion. Go up here to script and select Map Engine again. Just add a new style, paste in the link. Let's name it Mapbox Custom Oil or something like that. But before hitting OK, go close to the beginning, move a bit ahead, and then somewhere there's 256. That's the resolution, it's 256, and then later on there's an add 2x. So it's 512 by 512 pixels. But if you just change this 256 to 512 and then hit OK, it will do 512 × 2, which is 1024, which is like 4 times the resolution of what we would have initially had. And that saves 4 times the tiles, which is really great for Fusion performance, but also really great because it speeds up the download process, because you don't need all those tiles. Really neat trick. And because this map style is called Standard Oil, let's go to Cleveland and just do some map animations for the Standard Oil company. I want to start by showing the continental USA, so let's just search for USA, click go. And this view is actually pretty close already, but I want to refine it a bit. There's these new navigation controls, so let's move by a few units to the right and maybe zoom out just a bit more, like this. Hide them away again and just save this as the first keyframe. And now move a few frames ahead, like 100, and search for Cleveland. And here in Cleveland, I want to pitch the map a bit. So let's open the controls again and just change the pitch value to, yeah, let's go to the maximum, which is 60 degrees. Also, I want to add a little bit of an animation. Right now we have kind of high quality again. Right now we have this, so it starts flat and then just pitches the whole map. And now let's add rotation for a good bit longer. Let's go to 40 degrees rotation. Now that might be a bit too much for the start. That's really dynamic, but the pitch animation is a bit stiff at the end. So let's go into the spline view, show only selected, and now select CompCon. Hit fit to view, so now we can see all of the animation curves. And I don't want to focus on XYZ. I want to focus on pitch and orbit. And here's a culprit, that one that's not smooth. So just hit S to make it follow the path that it already has. And here at the end, hit S again. To finish things off, I want to add a location pin, and I'm actually working on a companion plugin set that has some really useful presets like pins and radars and so on, but it's not finished yet, not nearly finished. But one thing that is finished is pin. Let's see what pin style 2 has to offer. I like the rounder pin style 2, so let's use that. Select pin 2 and then hit create image at view. To get the pin connected up to the merge, we have to add in an image plane 3D, and then we have to look at the outputs. This right here is the shape output, and then there's the rendered output. And now I want to have this up and down animation, so I will just go to start, and then a few frames ahead, and change this value. Go to spline, hit S, and then with the keyframe selected, I want to click on set ping pong. As a final touch, I want to rotate the pin to always face the camera. So right here, the pin comes into the view, minus 10 degrees, set a keyframe, and then let's go to the end right here. This is how you add custom map styles. Of course, the animations I've created today are really, really basic. If this was for a documentary, you could, for example, add a newspaper article of the beginning of Standard Oil and then transition to that and then do 2D motion graphics right there. The map animation is not the star of the show, but it's a really neat way to show where you are in the world. That's been it for today. I hope you found this video helpful. Have a nice day and goodbye.